The views, comments, and opinions of the following program do not necessarily reflect those of Morris Media Studios, MorrisMediaLive.com, or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised. Care about Monday, I don't care about Tuesday, I don't care about Wednesday, I don't care about Saturday, nothing, none of that. Thursday is my favorite day of the week because of this moment right here. It's your girl, Shelly Shell, in the building. I'm so hyped right now. I had a great week, been having a great month, you feel me? I love y'all so much, I really do. Thank y'all for watching. This show is going to be really interesting. We're going to do something a little different this time. Usually we go through the topics and then talk to the guests. But this time we're going to talk to the guests first and then go through the topics. Because, you know, this guest is so important right now. He got so many things to do. It's ridiculous. This is a really good friend of mine, too, in comedy and in real life. Welcome to the show, Malcolm Hall. You know what I'm saying? You know we have a different
guest. What's up, everybody?
There we go.
Yeah.
What's going on, Malcolm?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
You looking good, too,
thank
right?
You. Got this nice chair. I got money. Got a studio. And that's look, I feel like I'm in a rocket ship. We about to go to space. I like this. Yeah. Put my good clothes on.
Yeah, I see you got your bright right on.
I did. I'm putting on some white.
Nah, man. Malcolm, I really appreciate you for coming.
You thank you for calling me.
One of my favorite people in comedy. You're hilarious.
Thank you.
And what people don't know is that you're very smart.
I am. And student loans were proven.
So how long have you been doing comedy?
I've been in comedy almost 9 years in October.
October got an anniversary. I met Malcolm. How did we meet?
We met at a comedy competition. So this is what happened. We had a comedy competition. At this time, I didn't have my car. And the bus broke down. I said, you know what? I left work early. I'm going to make this competition. So I got off the bus and I ran to Hollywood. Soon as I got there, Terrence DeLane was hosting.
Mm-hmm,
didn't
I
know
that.
Anybody. I have been out here maybe a year or so.
At the Chinese Theater.
At the Chinese Theater. He's like, you're next. I'm like, okay, cool.
Right.
Went, did my set, had a good set. Shelly comes behind me and starts roasting me. Damn, boy, that nigga tired as hell. I'm here trying to run, do the comedy. Maybe she get a car first. I'm like, ooh, I don't think we're going to be friends talking to me like that. But here we are.
That was funny. Yeah. And I almost won that competition, too. I came in second, but that was fun. And that was the start of our friendship.
That was the start of our friendship. Through competition, how many people get to be friends through competition?
Yeah, for real.
Because in comedy, people are so competitive.
They are. It's not enough. They act like it's not enough room for everybody.
It's enough. Everybody, some guys going to go on. Some ladies are going to do hosting. Some people are going to do stand-up. Some people are going to do movies. It's what you want to do. Everybody can't. You can't do everything.
You can't.
You can't.
But one of my most favorite things about you, Malcolm, is the conversations we have about finance. Now, Malcolm, let me just say this. Malcolm is not gay. And I always have to like specify this because, you know what I'm saying, this is a lesbian show and we do cater to the LGBTQ community. But look how good I can say that now.
I'm a lesbian. I like women.
No, a lesbian is a woman who likes women.
Oh.
So, but...
What's
the... I always say that the ally is your ally.
Oh, I'm an ally.
An ally is somebody who's not gay but supports the community. You right. know what I mean? And just like, hey, you fuck who you want, just don't try to fuck on me. We good.
Hey, yeah, gay, straight, whoever, your taxes don't get paid, you're going to jail. So we are all buddy. Subject to the same laws and everything.
That's true. And I always say allies are the most important people because, you know, because of you, we get to live in harmony and peace.
Right.
Without the drama. So, welcome, Malcolm, to the show, one of our allies. And he going to educate us because, look, listen, if you don't got your money right, I don't care how much your girl love you, she's not going to be as happy as you think she is. Mm-hmm. Like, and you're not going to be as happy as you think you are. As much as I've tried to avoid money, I've tried to avoid, like, this is how I tried to avoid the rat race.
I remember this. Remember? I do remember. You like, you know, money's not important.
Yeah, yeah.
We got I'm saying to myself, we'll see.
We had a conversation in his house while going over some sketches, eating some Popeye's chicken.
Right.
Standing yep. up, eating some chicken.
100, yes, this is 100% true. We were eating Popeye's. 100% true.
And I was telling him, man, money ain't nothing. Your name is everything. You got to make your name popping, and then the money will come. Ooh. And he was like, yeah, but what about the money you got right now? What are you doing with that? What about, I'm like, man, that's nothing. You don't need that. I'm out the rat race saying all this stupid shit, right? Come to find out, here we are years later, and I'm realizing, hey, I need to get my finances in order. Hey, I need to find out how this money game works. You feel me? Because yeah. it's a game being played on me. And if I don't know how to play, I'm going to lose every time.
You're gonna lose.
And I see, and I always say, look, I'm a 3-time loser. You feel me? I'm a woman, I'm black, and I'm a lesbian.
What? That's what y'all call yourselves?
3-time loser. Because at the end of the day, the cards are stacked against each one of those categories off the back. You feel me? So you have to go through a lot more just... Well, now being a lesbian is a little bit more cooler. So, you know, that's not so much. But being black and a woman, you got to try to get this money. It's harder. It's getting easier. It's getting a lot easier.
It is a lot easier because the access to information is ridiculous. If you can sit there and search Instagram, if you can sit there and read Twitter, if you can sit there and read Facebook, you can read an article on how to improve your money, how to save your money, and how to make some money. Because there's two types of people in this world. There's people who earn money, people who make money. If I earn money, if I earn money, unless you open the shop, I can't do anything. If I make money, there's four people out here I can do business with. And if you're not available, I can go to the next person. So if I'm making money, I have more access to it. I can get it more ways. If I'm earning it, I can only get it from this one stream of water. That's all I have. If I'm making money, I'm pumping my own water. Okay. And I have three pipes.
Right.
So if this pipe clogged, I got two more.
Okay.
So I'm giving myself options. Now, the pressure may not be the same.
Right.
This one might, that one stream of money might flow a little harder, but when it cut off, it cut off.
Right.
Mine flows slower, but steady.
Slow but steady.
Steady money.
That's my whole motto. Like, slow but show. That's what my great grandmother used to say. Slow but show.
Money takes time.
You have a brand, and it's called Cheap Not Broke. Now, I love this brand.
It's
a lifestyle.
Right.
It's a mentality. It's how you're thinking about something. So explain that to me. What do you mean by cheap, not broke?
Cheap, not broke is how you live, is how you eat, is how you think. It's everything. Okay. Cheap, not broke means I have money, I'm just not giving it all away. Because you can be cheap and not broke, which means this costs $10, but let me go see if I can find it for $8.
Okay.
It's just taking a little more time to spend your money and be smarter with it. People, impulse.
Yeah.
You get hungry. Oh, let me just go buy some food. You might go spend $13. Now, you could have spent $20 and ate for 6 days.
Mm-hmm.
But you just got hungry, wanted to go spend $13 for some food. You're hungry again at 7 o'clock that night. You can end up spending $30 a day on food.
That is so me.
And you could have bought $30 worth of food for 5 days.
That is so me. I spend so much money on food, it's ridiculous.
And people just have this thing, I'm hungry, I got to eat. Like, no, it's discipline, it's willpower. Like, are you really, you're not hungry right now.
But we're trained for fast food, though.
Red, you see it, you stop. I don't eat fast food anymore.
Okay.
I don't watch TV anymore.
About how much money you think you save by not eating fast food?
I save, I don't know. I do have a budget, though.
Okay.
If I go to work, so I give myself at least, I say, a $7 a day budget.
Okay.
7 times 5, $35 a week.
$35 a week.
That's it. You can't live off $35. What you eating?
What are you eating?
Stop buying the drink. Just get the food. Don't buy the drink. You drink water at the job. Be smart. Be cheap, not broke.
Okay.
Eat if it work if food is free at work, eat at work. Take your lunch. Do what you can. Be smart. If you want to eat out, treat yourself on Fridays so you can get something better on Friday than eating crap all week.
Okay, so listen. Now, a lot of people are in credit debt.
Oh.
I just recently paid off everything on my credit.
Hallelujah. That's great.
So what I'm doing, I'm waiting for that number to update. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
So everybody, my advice to people is to go to Credit Karma and find out what's on your credit score. A lot of people are ignorantly broke. They don't know why they're broke.
Right.
They don't know who they owe, how much they owe.
Or they don't know what broke is.
Exactly.
Like, do you understand what broke is? Broke is like literally not having access to money at all. Now, some people, speaking of credit, I have a credit camp called Stress Free Money Camp. It's tomorrow. Mm-hmm. You can come by. It's $25. Mm-hmm. We go over what it is. What I try to teach people how to travel with their credit, get travel points. Okay. So if you're paying your rent, you're paying your car insurance. If you spend like $3,000 on certain cards, you get like $20,000 worth of points.
So how do you get, okay, so how do I get the card though?
You just apply. You got to have at least a 600 some credit score.
How do I get there? Think about it, Malcolm. Everybody, most of the people I know, they're somewhere between 485 and 540.
You get there by checking your credit report and understanding what it means and what you're reading. Because you got different accounts on there. Mm-hmm. You got your auto, your home, mortgage, other, and student loans. So a lot of people have things to collect. Fraud. Do you buy gas?
Yeah.
Okay. If you swipe your debit card anywhere public, you're at risk for fraud. Okay. Somebody can take that card and buy all kind of stuff on it. Same thing with your credit card. Somebody can get your Social Security. Your Social Security is floating around everywhere. Somebody can get off Google. It's just that simple. Somebody get your Social Security number, open a credit card in your name, and buy stuff. You will never know this because the credit card statement is not coming to your house. It's going to hit your credit report. It's not going to hit your credit report till 90 days. 90 days past due. Now it's going to hit you on a ding. Now it's going to show it's past due with collections. The collection is going to call you in 180 days. Now you're stuck. Because you got 6 months worth of crap on your credit report because you didn't check it. Check your credit report once a year. It's foolish. When is the last time you checked anything important once a year?
Nothing. It. How often do you think we should check your credit report?
I check my credit report every week.
Me too.
Because things are constantly updating. Yeah. Something reports on the 17th. Something reports on the 1st. Something reports on the 13th. So you got to check the dates. Because they make mistakes too.
So at your credit, that's why I brought up the credit. Because you have the credit camp. Where is it going to be and from what time?
It's in Venice Beach. It's from, you can find it on Eventbrite, Stress-Free Money Camp. It starts at 11 o'clock. It ends at 1 p.m. And
that's this Saturday.
That's this Saturday.
Now, this is important because at your camp, are you going to show us how to dispute things? Like, what?
We get into all that. Okay. I teach you how to dispute. I teach you everything. I'm teaching you how to fish. Because my motto is, I can repair your credit for you, but what happens when you get a flat again? You're going to have to call AAA and wait a couple of days.
Right.
Or you can get this thing going and go on your own. Like, you need to know this because not only do you know how to prepare your credit, you want to buy a house one day.
Yeah.
You want to buy some property one day.
Right.
You need, for example, if you have $100, I have $100.
Right.
I got a credit card, $500.
Mm-hmm.
You got $100 cash. I got $600. We're both going out to eat. You spend money, you got $50. I got $550 left.
Right.
Oh, but I still have access to money because I still have $50 cash plus my $500. So I can make a payment or I can pay cash.
Yeah.
So I'm going to make a payment on my credit card, $25, yeah. Right? You're down $50 in the hole because you have no credit. Mm-hmm. I'm going to make a payment this week and I'm going to make a payment in 2 weeks.
Right.
So I still have money available. When you're burning cash, you don't have any money.
So are you saying responsibly live through your credit card?
Yeah, if you know how. It takes discipline and it takes management. That's why I have a portion in my class called credit management. You got to know how to manage it.
Do you consult for finances personally?
I do.
Would you be a what do you call it?
I'm a counselor. I'm the kind of guy. I'm gonna hit you up on Friday night like 9 o'clock. What you doing? What you spending money on? Cause I know most people's biggest problem is Friday night. You just get paid. Oh, I'm gonna go treat myself.
Yeah.
Go eat. Party with your friends. You down $120. Oh, you didn't think about AT&T. You didn't think about SoCalGas. Car insurance. Because you think you're busy treating yourself. Well, them people owe money. They gave you a service.
Right.
So it's only fair.
So, okay. So let's say I'm starting with bad credit, right?
Right.
I'm going to take your class.
Mm-hmm. Your credit is not an STD. It won't kill you.
Right. You're going to help me update my shit.
Mm-hmm.
Get my stuff together.
Right.
In the in-between time, what can I do right now to build my credit? What is one thing that I could do to start building my credit?
Well, it's hard because it depends on the situation you're in. So if you have good credit, I'm going to say, well, you should probably get some travel cards and try to go travel and take some vacations or go buy something that has value. Don't go buy some shoes. Shoes don't hold no value. if your credit's bad, I'm going to say, go get a secure card. Go get a card for $500, save up money, get that card, get it with a bank, and start making payments on it.
Now, this is key right here. The secure credit cards, this will raise your credit dramatically.
Yes.
So what you want to do, now I've done this. What you want to do is get a secure card. They have one that's a minimum of $300. Mm-hmm. If you're serious about your finances, you could save $300. You better figure out a way to get the $300.
It's discipline. It takes.
So what you do is you give them the $300 up front, and that's your credit limit.
Right.
Now, what do I do with that $300 responsibly? Because I know you can't go over 30% of your utilization of a credit card.
I would just buy gas. I would say if the credit is $300, 30% of that. $100. Yeah, $30. Yeah, you're not really going to do that. I say $100.
Okay.
$100. No more than $100. Okay. Don't give yourself cushion. Don't go over $85.
Okay.
I would use $85 a month, and I would do that consistently for 5 months.
And
watch my credit change.
Approximately how many points? It depends on.
It depends on how much debt you're in, what you got on your credit. So it's the thing. And in the class, I try to teach you, you know, you have to learn your situation. Because what I'm dealing with is different than what you're dealing with. I might have more debt than you. Mm-hmm. You may have more debt than me. Mm-hmm. I might have more income than you. So it's a debt to income ratio.
It is.
It's a debt to income ratio.
And that's one of the hardest things to understand is a debt to income ratio. Explain a little bit without giving too much from your camp.
We can get in there 6 hours. The camp. So just give you a little background. The camp, we cover the credit report. I go in through collections. I go in through how to read your credit report. What does everything mean? How does this affect you? The reporting dates, the due date and reporting dates are different. I go in through credit management. How much do you make a month? Mm-hmm. How much are you planning to spend in credit? What are your utilities? What are you really spending your money on? Because some people, I don't know. Right. Then who are you working for?
Yeah, that's me.
And then the last thing, we go over the rewards points. Once you get your credit in good shape, how to apply for different cards, how to use those cards as leverage. Because if I got $100, why wouldn't I go use my $100 on my credit card? Because if something happens, I still have $100 cash.
Right.
So you use credit, so you have cash all the time. So it's like I have two pools of money.
Right. Okay. All right, so that's deep right there. So two pools of money. Okay.
That's how rich people stay rich, because I might have $1 million cash, but I got $9 million in credit.
Right.
That's how I get my money. Because now, so you're trying to operate on cash. I got credit. I'm going to go buy more than you. We both got $1 million. I got $9 million cash. I can go buy $4 million worth of capital.
But now somebody would say, like, you know, this is how people get in trouble right here. Like, right. They get these credit cards and then they max them out. And then you're in $9 million debt and you only have $1 million to pay it all off.
But with that saying, I'm running a business, so I'm making money with my credit. Mm-hmm. See, there's business credit and there's personal credit. Now you have to have a business. But if you're using credit for business, I'm going to use that $4 million and go buy $4 million worth of something I can sell. So if I can buy something for $4 million and sell it $2 a piece, I'm going to make $8 million. I make $8 million.
Pay off the $4 million and I pocket it $4 million.
Boom. You're still broke.
I'm still broke.
Because you don't got no credit.
Right.
But we're doing the same thing.
Right.
You can't afford to buy. You only bought $500,000 worth of merchandise. Right. I bought $4 million.
So use your credit to buy something that you could double.
Right.
And make money off of your credit.
That's how businesses work. No business is out here running off cash. You can never do that.
You don't even know how easy it is to call in, callers, 323-293-3375. If you have a question, a financial question you want to ask Malcolm Hall, let us know right now. He's only here for 10 more minutes. Call in, 323-293-3375. So, what was I about to ask you?
Oh, we're talking about credit. Like, if you have money,
All right.
You use the credit because at the end of the day, let's use the same situation. I got $1 million. You have $1 million. But I have, I went and borrowed $9 million worth of money, but I only purchased $4 million. Right. So I still have money left. You don't go borrow $9 million and spend $9 million.
Right.
You spend half of it.
Right.
Because I still have some insurance.
And try to double that
half. I'm going to double that half or make more than that. So I just gave you an easy number, too. But what if I sold it at $5 million? I tripled my money by 5%, 500%.
Right.
And then I pay back the $9 million.
Right.
And then I still have money left over. That's how people make. Let me give you real simple. I got $5.
Right.
All right. I'm broke.
Okay.
I'm broke. Okay. And you got $10.
Right.
And let me borrow $5 from you. Okay, cool. I take that $10. I go buy something for, let's say, $10. Mm-hmm. I spend all my money. but I'm going to go sell it for five. What I just bought for 10 bucks, I just bought 10 items for $1. I'm going to sell each of them at five.
Mm-hmm.
How much am I going to make?
50.
Thank you. Okay, now I give you your 10. I give you your 10 back.
No, five. You only brought five.
Oh, I'm right back. Oop, my bad. I give you your five back.
Right.
Hey, I just walked away with $40.
45.
45, my bad.
Damn.
I just made money with your money. That's how banks work. That's how loans work. I borrow money from you. I go buy more, sell it for more, come back, give you yours, and I walk away. Mm-hmm. I start to think, like, really think about this, people. I'm using your money to make more than you.
Mm-hmm.
That's how business works. People don't see it like that. I go. That's when you go get the loan, go buy something, sell it for three times as much, pay the loan back, and walk away with profit. That's how you make money.
Malcolm Hall, y'all in the building, trying to tell us how to get this money. So your workshop is this Saturday.
This Saturday, June 30th.
Now Venice Beach is kind of big. Is there
it's on event? Yes, I can give you the specific address right now.
Yeah, it is. Let us know, because people are gonna just be showing up to Venice Beach like, Malcolm,
hey, where's this guy?
Malcolm, where? Fix my credit.
Well, the reason why I didn't put the address out there for safety reasons.
Okay.
I wanted people to actually sign up and be
there. Well, just give us the Eventbrite.
Yeah, it's just if you go to Stress Free Money. If you go to Stress Free Money Camp on Eventbrite, or you can go to Black Kung Fu on Instagram, or you can go to Cheap Not Broke on Instagram, all three places, or Malcolm Hall Black Kung Fu on social media, you can find three places to sign up for the event. It's $25. You're going to leave with $1 million worth of information.
Woo-hoo,
I got some a lot of good stuff. This is for everybody, and it's an open conversation.
Yeah.
I want you to tell you, hey, I got bad credit.
Yeah.
Because I'd say your credit's not an STD. It's not going to kill you, because people like STDs, they don't want to tell anybody.
Right.
But if you don't tell anybody, you don't know this is curable.
Yeah.
You'll mess around and die. Because you didn't know you could have went and got this cured.
That's what I say. People are ignorantly broke. You don't even know why you're broke or how broke you are. That's right. The first thing that I had to figure out. Okay, what are my debts? That's what I did. I said, okay, I'm about to get out of debt. I'm about to stop playing. I'm about to get financially stable. So what I did was I looked up everything in my name. I said, who do I owe money to?
Right.
How much do I owe? Then I budgeted that money. I got a second job. I budgeted that money into my paycheck.
Key word, you got a second job, because you got to make more. It's like a rat race.
Yeah, it is.
You got to make more than the debt. You got to stay
you
ahead
gotta
of it.
Yes.
You can't never let it catch up to you. It's like running a race with your debt. If your debt ever catches up to you, you're in trouble.
Yeah.
You need to stay like seven paces ahead of debt.
And see, that's where I was. I was neck and neck with my debt with one job. It wasn't working. Right. I was with the one job and I wasn't able to pay off nothing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It was like,
you're constantly getting, that's how the payday loan people work.
Oh yeah.
You gotta come back and get more money.
I just paid off Speedy Cash. You know what I'm saying? Like,
and that's it. People, if you had a credit card with $15,000, that's why they take advantage of people. They're not in white neighborhoods because white people go to Chase Bank and get credit cards. Mm-hmm. They're in black neighborhoads because black people don't go do that.
We get payday loans. Borrow,
you go get payday loans at like 30, 40, 100%. Yeah. Go get you something with a controlled interest rate. Do you know? You can get you something fixed. I got a Capital One venture right now. No interest for 1 year.
I got that Capital One too.
It's nice.
Capital One is no. I don't have the new. I have the little dark blue one.
That's what I got.
Okay, yeah.
That's two times the miles?
Yeah.
Yeah. You spent your $3,000?
No.
Oh. $3,000, you get $200 to travel. You got to spend $3,000. Just buy everything on your credit card. Secret. Set up an account for your credit cards.
Mm-hmm.
Pay everything out of there.
Right, and then
don't mix. You gotta have more accounts. I'm giving you all the information. Have a couple of accounts to do business out of.
Right.
Have your bill account. Have your personal account. Have your fun account. Have your saving money account. How am I? Oh my God, shit's fucked up account.
Right,
you gotta have them. It's free to have a bank.
It is. And so what I recommend you do is every paycheck, put something away, like itemize it in an envelope. You gotta get organized.
$25 a week is $1,200 a year.
Bam.
Easy.
You know what I'm... Little shit like that. Like, we be in debt and be broke for years. You feel me?
Interest. Like, you gotta come to the class. I'll tell you. Oh, interest is like a rope. Interest is like a rope. And it just... Come... You just can't... just keep pulling you back until you understand. Oh, you gotta cut the rope.
Gotta cut the rope, man. So, like, to stop this just forever brokenness, you feel me? First thing first, go to his class Saturday at Venice Beach, Stress-Free Money. Credit Camp on Eventbrite.
On Eventbrite.
And if you can't make it...
I have it. I'm going to have it again in a couple weeks.
Okay.
Definitely going to put out the word again.
You got a flyer, right?
I will have a flyer. I'm in the process of building the website. So this is my second class.
Okay, you just started.
I just started because I talk to people all the time about this stuff. So let me have a class Let me show everybody.
What?
Because everybody's affected. I don't care who you are, you know, sexual orientation, color, race. What's your credit? It's like your criminal background.
Yeah.
If your credit is bad, you damn near a felon.
It don't matter what you are, gay, black, straight, white, green is green.
Yeah.
And if you don't know how to handle this green, you're gonna be in trouble. So See what's in your name. See who you owe. See how much you owe.
Check your credit report.
Check your credit report and then start budgeting. Like, I never budgeted. I always would just get my money and then figure out what I want to do that day. Like, okay, I do got to pay my phone, but let me do that. And then whatever was happening at the time, I would have a good time. And then these issues would come and I wouldn't have the money for it.
Now it's like, hey, some days for me, I'm like, you know what? I'm not spending no money for the next 2 days.
So I've been doing that. I'll buy
everything I need on one day. And for the next 2 days, if I don't have it, I'm just going to do it out.
I have been doing that. I've been sitting around like, you know what? If I could make it without spending money, let me see how long I could go without spending any cash.
If you don't.
What do I need? See, this is what I've learned about money. You got to figure out what you need and what you want. Like you talked about impulses. Our impulses are nasty out here in America.
I don't watch TV because of that. It triggers you to buy too much stuff.
They're nasty. We buy everything all the time because we want to. I want. Our impulses are disgusting. Like if you just sit and really think about what you need. Okay, I need water. Bam, I got the water. I got a meal for this. I got 3 meals a day. I'm good. If you don't buy nothing unnecessarily, you'll have hundreds of dollars in your... You'll be so surprised how much money you have in your pocket.
Or be like me. Like, I boil my own tea at home.
Okay.
I don't buy tea. I make my own drinks at home. I try to buy
stuff... Cheap, not broke.
Cheap, not broke. Right. I buy stuff wholesale. So when I buy things, I buy stuff at like 4 at a time.
Right.
Because it's cheaper per unit. So, like, get on Amazon. Like, if it's something you buy all the time, just buy it in bulk. So you don't have to buy it all the time. Another thing I do is, like, renting air control. Like, drink you some water. If you're sitting in your house sweating, just drink you some water. Keep yourself cool. It's healthy for you. Do the smart things to save money. I use public transportation.
Me too.
It's cheaper on parking. I park my car and just ride.
Yeah.
Because I can ride the Metro $25 a week anywhere I want to go in the city that the Metro goes. But that same $25 is not going to cover my parking. It's not going to cover a ticket.
Right.
So you got to be smart and look at your situation and like what works best for you. I travel all the time, but I find a hell of a lot of travel deals.
Yeah, you the one who taught. He taught me that buying airline tickets on Tuesday is cheaper than any other day of the week.
It's cheaper than any other because they purge the flights. They drop them because they need to fill up the flights for the weekend, Friday and Saturday. So like, you know what? Let's purge it. Let's drop the flights so we can fill it up. Okay, we're not making money at $100. We're gonna drop it down to $75.
Malcolm Hall, man. He's one of the smartest black men when it comes to finances. Some of the best financial conversations I've ever had.
And you can come see me tell jokes. I do tell jokes.
Yeah.
I'm funny. I tell jokes.
Where are you telling jokes tonight?
Tonight, I'm at... Man, I don't know. I'm at some hood spot tonight. I don't know.
He on Manchester and Van Ness.
I'm on Manchester and Van Ness. We right next to the car wash.
It's a Jiffy Lube or
it's
something.
It's a Jiffy Lube. Yeah, it's something like that. But yeah. It's new. I'm going to get you down there.
I'm going to come after the show.
But I do want to say this to the community and everybody. Finances is important. And I know that oftentimes people fall in love and you forget about your money.
Oh,
I know. I do know now it is legal that lesbians and the gay community can get married. You are bound to the state. You will get a divorce. It's going to cost you a whole lot of money. So, with that being said, you're just like everybody else now. You will find yourself in court spending a lot of money. When you adopt children, you are responsible. You do have to pay child support now. So, your finances have been affected by the law. With rights come debts.
Hey.
That's the way it is.
When marriage was illegal, I was like,
partnership was free.
Yeah, it was double income.
Yeah. Your income is getting, it's not really,
For the love, yes.
Yeah, for the love, yes.
Finances.
Not
we was winning.
So
we was winning without the legal
thing. Yeah, you want the right to get married, but when you split up, your property belongs to the state, and the state is going to separate it.
Ouch. That hurts. I don't like the way that sounds. I've been watching straight men go through this for the longest. I'm like, ooh, that's fucked up. Now
welcome
I'm like,
to the club.
Yeah, now I'm like, fuck.
What you here for? Divorce? Yeah.
Shit.
I wish we had it like y'all.
Man, I really appreciate you for. Go ahead. You want to say something else?
Oh, yeah. I say thank you for having me.
Yeah, for
I appreciate
sure.
you. Please show Shelly some love. This is wonderful what she has going on here. I definitely want to come back. Anytime you need me, call
always,
me.
Man, always.
I'm always happy to come talk about money, taxes,
I want to talk about taxes because, you know, a lot of people don't. Black people have been filing taxes all wrong, I feel like. We've been claiming other motherfuckers'
kids. The 1040 form just changed. It's going to change in 220. It got shorter.
Okay.
However, I think you have to pay per form. So I don't know if this is a good thing.
Okay.
So the 1040 form is going to be smaller, but that means you have to pay per form for deductions. That means it's going to cost your tax preparer more money. Taxes is the biggest scam in America.
Mm-hmm.
We all have to pay them and don't nobody know how to do them. Ain't that a bitch.
Man, I wish you had more time to talk about these taxes because I'm just now learning about tax deductions and what you can actually take off on your tax. It's so much things, so many things that we're not deducting.
A business, a lot of us as black people, when you run a business, everything is tax deductible. Me
mm-hmm.
driving my car is a business expense.
Mm-hmm.
You driving your car to work as an employee, you're just driving to work.
Mm-hmm.
But when I own something, it's different. When I have a production company, we pay Malcolm Hall, you're paying Malcolm Hall, the production company. So I'm just an employee
right.
of my production company.
Right.
So when you sue me, you're not suing me, suing the company.
Right.
I don't have no money.
And it's really easy to sound to start a company.
Yeah, get
I think
an LLC.
It's like $26.
It's like 300 something.
Well, not the LLC. I'm talking about the DBA.
Oh, yeah, DBA. Yeah, well,
that's
I would
what
say.
I did with Let's Talk. It's like $26.
LegalZoom, yeah. You don't listen to some podcasts, read about it, know what you're doing, because there is a huge LGBT community is humongous
because yeah.
people like to feel comfortable
yeah.
where they're at.
Yeah.
So, like what you're doing, people like to feel comfortable hearing like people like them.
Right, right.
So, hey.
It is, and there is a gay-owned bank. I didn't get to get the name, but Google it. Gay-owned, there is a gay-owned bank if you want to support. Get these gay dollars and let's bring all our gay dollars together. You know what I'm saying? Like, we'll be balling.
Yeah. Hey, gay, straight, they all spend the same.
Yeah. Malcolm is all about his money. That's what I love about him. Hey, we're going to have Malcolm back again. We're going to talk about taxes.
Thank you. Cheap Not Broke. Follow me at Black Kung Fu on Instagram. Follow me. Follow my Cheap Not Broke page. CheapNotBroke.com. Buy a t-shirt like this. And hold on, Shelly. Got something for you.
Oh, no, you don't. Oh, no, you don't. Don't fucking.
Gotcha.
Bam.
Gotcha.
Cheap, not broke. Gotcha. Man, I'm about to put this on right now because, you know.
What's your shirt size?
My shirt size extra large. I can do an extra large.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Glad you ain't asking about pants because, you know, we wouldn't be in this moment. I appreciate this. Malcolm, I'm about to get a cheap, not broke.
Oh, yeah. I had to. Gotta show some love.
No, I appreciate that.
Bam.
Bam.
Cheap not broke right there. Right
cheap
now.
Not broke, baby.
Cheap not broke. Check them out.
Hey, support the brand.
Support the brand.
Malcolm Hall in the building.
Show some love, man. We saving money. Being cheap. Man, listen.
Come to this class tomorrow. I swear, you're not going to regret this.
It's right across the street from the Venice Lease Library. If you take Venice all the way down, you'll see it. But like I said, if you get on Eventbrite, you get there, you'll find it. There's a doorbell. I got it in a real safe place for security. So I just want everybody to feel safe.
Is it dangerous over there, bro?
No, it's a nice area.
Okay.
But I just know there's crazies. I got an address out there and I got a group of people.
Okay.
So I just feel responsible for people's safety.
I appreciate
so I just
that.
Wanted to make sure I had a safe place for everybody to come and learn.
And I'm going to post it on IG. So you're going to give me the information, post it on IG.
Yes, I will.
We're going to take a break and let Malcolm go to this this hood open
yep.
mic. I'm
going to
meet him there. I'm going to meet you here after the show.
All
and
right.
I appreciate you for coming out. Thank you for the gift.
All right,
man.
Everyone.
Thank you. So we're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Girl,
back, y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed Malcolm Hall. You feel me? He dropped a couple of jewels on us. Cheap, not broke. Got my t-shirt. I'm really, really pumped about wearing this right here. Like, really, 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 really pumped. I need to get my merch up. You feel me? I got to get my merch up. So, it's just us right now. Well, just me for the rest of half of the show. Got my cheap, not broke situation. I'm really pumped about the financial information that he just gave you guys. Just to recap real quick. Like, you know what I'm saying? See what's in your name. See who you owe. Get a secure credit card. Save up for that. They have a minimum of $300 ones. Buy your stuff on there. Don't go over $100. Pay that off. In about 4 months, you'll see a dramatic increase in your credit. That's just a little tidbit to get you started. Get your money right. Because guess, best and believe, your woman not going to stick around. You know what I'm saying? If it's years and years and years of broke after broke after broke, she going to leave, bro. So, like, get your money together. And you're not going to be happy. Like, I've been dealing with being broke or financially ignorant. You know what I'm saying? That's really what it is. It's not that we broke. We get this money. It's just we don't know what to do with it. You know what I'm saying? We buying chains. We buy chains. We buy all type of unnecessary stuff when we get this money. You feel me? I know I'm not the only one who paycheck is spent before they even get here. You know what I'm saying? You know you get paid on Friday. You already done bought shoes. You already done went to the club in your head. So when your check come, you already pre-broke. So it's like, at this point, we too old, and finances has not been talked enough in the Black community, the gay community. We got to get it together, you feel me? I just paid off all my credit. I'm about to be flexing in a minute, and I want y'all to be flexing with me. So, check Malcolm Hall out and Cheap Not Broke. Speaking of that, one of the things that's going to help us with our finances is if we recirculate our dollars. We have sat back and watched the Mexicans do this all our lives. You feel me? They keep their money in their city. They buy their own corn. The little man come around with the little thing. Ding, 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 ding. Everybody come out. You feel me? They spend their money with him. He go spend his money with the orange man by the freeway. He's selling cherries and strawberries. That man go spend that money at the pupusa lady. They keep all their money together. You feel me? So I want to make sure that we do that too. Support each other. All I've been doing is buying and supporting people in our community so far. Website that I'm excited about that I just bought some stuff from is Black Dollars Matters, and I got me a Malcolm X hat. This shit is like cold. Do you see the Malcolm X hat? $10. Black Dollars Matter. Support your people, man. I got this one, and I'm most excited about this right here. This Living Single hat. Do you see this Living Single hat? I'm gonna kill them this summer right here. They getting killed with this one right here. You feel me? So recirculate that money. If you see somebody in your community, buy from them. Like, you're not going to catch me in Jordans anymore. You're not going to catch me supporting these other brands anymore. I'm supporting you. Just like I want you to support me. You feel me? We got to support each other. So with that being said, I want to give a congratulations to this couple right here. This is the 1,000th follower couple right here, okay? Yeah, they got me right here. They finessed me. You feel me? I appreciate them for supporting. So what happened was the girlfriend in the back, right? She was 1,000th follower. So then I had lost some followers, and then her girlfriend ended up being the new 1,000th follower. So they both got $100. They both got laced by Les Talk with $100. Moni and T, go follow their YouTube page. They got a Whisper challenge up right now. I fucks with this couple because they finessed me out of $200 and they supported me. But that's what happens when you support Less Talk. You feel me? You get that money. So if you ain't supporting Less Talk, you probably broke because I'm handing out hundreds. I'm sending hundreds, and that's all the way to Maryland. You feel me? So let me know what's up with that. Congratulations, Moni and T. I appreciate y'all for the support. Let's see what's going on. Girl Crush of the Week. One of my favorite segments, because you know I love the ladies. That's why I got this show, because I love the ladies. There she go. You see when they grow up? I mean, more and more of these young girls are getting finer and finer. You got to be careful. Now, R. Kelly, I don't appreciate what he's doing, but I'm not going to say I understand, but I can see where you could go wrong. Guess what I'm saying? I can see where you could get led astray, because some of these young girls is looking real good. This is Rue from, her real name is Amandla Stenberg, and she was from The Hunger Games, and she's the Girl Crush of the Week. She just came out as gay this week, and I'm very excited for that. not because I'm about to do no creep shit, but because, you know, I feel like in 6 years, it'd be okay to slide in her DMs. So, Amandla, and I like that I thought your name was Amanda, but it was an L right there. That's sexy. I'm gonna be DMing you, girl. Just wait a couple years. I'm gonna be. She was rude. Remember, she was the little girl in the room. I feel bad for having a crush on her now because when we first seen her, she was a little girl. But she's not a little girl no more because I'm not a creep. Anyway, this is the girl crush of the week. She fine. And she just came out. So shout out to you. This girl crush is for you. Oh, hey. I'm so hyped. Okay, I'm pumped. My monster kicked in. You feel me? My little monster kicked in. So I think it was Wednesday, right? I reposted something from Tessa Thompson. You feel me? She watched the story on IG and like responded. I had like a little poll. She responded to the poll, y'all. We going up. Tess Thompson, shout out to you, girl. So I appreciate you for sharing that information and for supporting Let's Talk. And come on the show, girl. Anyway, we on our way. Don't even trip. Let's see. Oh, I don't know if you guys read comic books, but I do. I love comic books, but a lot of times the comic books are so misogynistic. They're so female gaze. They have the female gaze. It's all about the female being sexy and voluptuous. And it really wasn't any lesbian comic books out. But then I researched it and I found out that there actually was, a lesbian comic book. And this was back in the 1970s. It was created by Mary Wings. It's called Come Out Comics. So this was actually the first literary queer comic book created by and for queer people. And it was pretty cool because, you know, she was just learning herself. I relate to her because she was just learning herself and learning that she liked women. And once she learned about the lesbian community, she wanted in. Same thing with me. I have been, you know, messing with straight women. I didn't even know about a lesbian community. Somebody was like, lesbians. I was like, what? And she felt the same way. Like, the first time she heard the word, she was like, what? What is that? So she got into the community and started writing these books. And they're really cool because they're, like, raw and unapologetically blunt. It get kind of weird, but this is the 70s. So, you know, they was probably on some shit. So it was cool. It was, like, psychedelic a little bit. But it was cool. She's still alive. She's living in San Francisco. And go ahead and look that up. It's called Come Out Comics. It's by Mary Wings. It was the first lesbian comic book. And back in the day, it was on everybody's toilet. Now we got a caller. Okay, because I'm always expecting the caller. POTUS be like, eh. But I'm always expecting the caller. And we do have a caller. And this is a caller that I knew was going to call. Very special person. She was a guest on the show last year. Sabrina Hooks. Welcome, Sabrina Hooks, to the show.
Hello.
What's up, Sabrina? How you doing, boo?
I'm doing okay. How about yourself?
I'm doing good, man. It's so good to hear from you because, you know, a lot of our callers were wondering what was going on with you. Just a brief recap. Sabrina was assaulted at a Jack in the Box last year, and, you know, it was very traumatic. This man, he just assaulted her. I don't even want to get too much into it because it was a traumatic experience for you. But what I wanted to say was how strong you came out of this, like a phoenix. I'm very proud of you for that. You came out of this situation stronger than before, and you know, we're very proud of you. Our listeners haven't stopped thinking about you. They've been wanting to know, how are you? So how are you?
Odd question to ask, but I'm doing better, I can say. I had to kind of go away for a while and just exclude myself from everything, even the investigation that was going on, because it just, I don't know, mentally it just really messed me up. I thought I was okay, and then I wasn't for a minute, and now I guess I'm kind of getting back to normal again.
And that's okay, Sabrina. It's okay to, you know, go away and get your shit together, pretty much. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Gather your mind and center yourself again, because sometimes a lot of things off-centers us, and it throws us off. You feel me? Off of our, well, however we were thinking, however we were feeling, and it makes us look at life differently. But what I want you to do is continue to look at life in a positive way. You know what I mean? Because, you know, I'm glad you made it out of that, all right? I have an article after this conversation to where, you know, sometimes it doesn't end with life. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes it could get way worse. So we're glad that you're here, and we're glad that you were able to get past that.
No, yeah, definitely something I wouldn't wish on even my worst enemies.
How has that that situation affected you, if you don't mind me asking?
Honestly, I, you know, I probably should look into, you know, some help as far as, you know, I do have bad anxiety now going in a crowd still. Like, that hasn't really gone away. I kind of don't party too much or, you know, I kind of stay to myself. So it's changed me as far as that. Like, I'm more chill, definitely. I kind of, for a brief moment, had to really check my anger because it had went just off. I just became angry at everything. Every little thing would set me off. And so just, now I'm getting back into trying to work out.
There we go.
You know, just getting my mind together, you know.
Have you tried meditating?
I actually, you know, do now. I try to wake up, you know, I try to put myself into a routine, you know, making the bed and laying out my clothes and, you know, and just thinking positive things. You know, my girl's definitely helping me with that because sometimes I still slip into the, oh, F everything, F life, F people.
Right, right.
So I can definitely say without her, I probably would have just slipped into a very dark place that I couldn't come back from. So.
Yeah, that love, her love is so important, and I could feel it even from the moment that I met her when you guys were here and you were telling me about the story and she started crying. And I was just looking at her like, man, that is a deep love, you know, when you really feel what someone else is feeling. Like, she really empathized with you, and she was really, you could tell she was in it for the long haul. So shout out to your girlfriend. I appreciate her. Because
Fiance now.
So. Hey, congratulations. Fiance, she deserved that. You better have put a ring on it, man. You better have put a ring on it, man. That's what you put the ring on right there. Somebody that stayed by your side, you feel me?
Yeah.
So I'm glad you had that support, and that's what, you know, is so important. And you know, I'm here for you. Let's Talk is here for you. You can always call me and work with us and do whatever it is you need to, you know, put yourself in a positive, supportive mind state and environment. We're here for you.
Well, thank you for that, man. Thank you so much.
And I want you to know I mean that. Like, call me if you need me. Like, come, we can go on a hike together. Like, I love the fact that you have a routine right now because you have to retrain your mind to think a certain way. Because sometimes our emotions affect us and make us lash out and think negatively about something. You know, like you said, like, fuck everything. But we have to train our mind. Our mentality is a verb. It's something that we're doing. You know what I'm saying? Thinking is doing something. You have to really train yourself to think positively and push yourself to do more positive things. So if you need me, we can go hiking. You know what I'm saying? And just chill out. You feel me?
Yeah.
And so what are you working on right now? I know you a photographer. What projects are you working on right now?
I actually, you know, it's prom season just ended, so I just got done doing all that. And honestly, I kind of sidetracked and took some old work that I was what people would call, you know, artsy-fartsy photography.
Okay. Artsy-fartsy.
And I switched it up and put it on, you know, clothing. So I got T-shirts and...
Oh, I did see that. Hey, that shit is dope. I did see that. That is dope. She's putting her art on T-shirts and crew neck sweatshirts. And, I mean, it's really dope. I can't wait to buy one and rep it on the show. Get a couple, rep them on the show. No, that's dope. That's a good idea. I did see that on your IG. That is going to go somewhere.
I hope so. Right now, it's just, you know, something to keep my mind occupied. My girl thinks I should stick with it, so.
I think you should, too. I think you should, too. I would even like for you, like we talked last week, I would love for you to take some pictures of me and maybe put them on a shirt. Like, I want to work with you. I've been wanting to work with you from the very beginning, you know, because I feel the strength in your spirit behind all this tragedy. You feel me?
Yeah.
I see the tragedy has affected you, but I see you keep pushing as a strong black woman. I see your real spirit behind that. And I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying, fuck with that spirit behind that. Like, come on now, Sabrina. Come back. It's okay, girl. Come on. Like, come on, girl. Come on out of there. Like, let's do some photography. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really care about you, Sabrina. I really do.
Well, thank you, man. That means a lot, especially nowadays. It's, you know, surprisingly, I saw after this whole incident, even with family, like, he was really there and he wasn't.
So yeah.
It's just definitely an eye-opener with everything.
Yeah, that's what happens. You, in tragedy, you find out who's there for you. But at the end of the day, you got to be there for yourself, and you got your girl. So we ain't going to worry about what's not. We're going to worry about what is. You feel me?
You're right.
And we appreciate you for calling in. I'm glad you're doing good. We gonna pump your shirts up, you know what I'm saying, on the IG, on Let's Talk IG. Just put DM me anything, and I'm going to pump it up for you. You already know. And let me know when I can get the link to buy something so I could be on it too. You feel me? Keep me fresh with your artwork. I saw it. It was nice.
Well, thank you, for sure. I'll see about that and get you something. For sure.
It's always a pleasure talking to you, and we're going to work together, and I'm going to see you soon. And, you know, just keep your spirits up.
All right, thank you, Shelly.
And thank you so much for calling.
No problem.
All right, have a good night. Bye, fiance.
Bye.
Bye. That's what I'm talking about. That's Sabrina right there. I know y'all remember Sabrina. She's doing great. She's about to come out with a new line of artsy t-shirts and crew necks. It's about to be lit, trust me. And the reason why I was so invested in this particular article with Sabrina is because, you know what I'm saying, a lot of us are assaulted, and sometimes it ends in death, just like it did here in South Africa. Like, this is where discrimination is a problem, when it starts leading to physical acts of harm. You know what I'm saying? You can feel how you feel, have your opinion, discriminate, not like this, not like that, whatever, whatever. That's your business. But when you start harming people and putting your hands on people, that's a problem. You feel me? For anybody, any community, black, white, gay, straight, that's a problem. Don't touch nobody. You feel me? That's a problem. So here in South Africa, there was a murder of Nozolo Zakika. I got to go to my ancestors to get this name right. Nozolo Zakika. Now, she was a lesbian with her girlfriend. They were at a party about 250 meters from her house. This was January 1st for the New Year's. So they were outside or whatever. And this happens a lot. You be with your girl having a good time. Y'all be looking happy. And then some dude is over there hating. So he was hating. He was spewing derogatory, names at her about her sexual orientation. And just getting belligerent. And a lot of times what we do is we don't want to look like a bitch in front of our girl. So it's like, shut up. You know what I'm saying? Shut up, bro. You try to, you know, poke your chest out and you're like, shut up. And so they got into a fight or whatever. And she hit him with a plank. Now, I had to look up what a plank was. This is some African stuff. I had to look up what a plank was. We don't have planks like laying around like that. That's just like a stack of like a log of wood, right? So she picked a plank up and hit him. Bow. And he stabbed her twice. And she died a couple of hours later. So the kicker part about this situation is that in South Africa, you know what I'm saying, they're not respecting the lesbian community enough to the point where he didn't even get arrested. He was let off with a warning. He walked out of the courthouse with a warning, bruh. And it was like, how do you get a warning for killing somebody? Even if you get arrested and you have to do bail, he didn't have to do any of that. No jail time, no bail, no nothing. So the court case starts back up in July 2nd is the next hearing. And they have a couple of organizations out there, one of them being the Triangle and Free Gender. And what they're doing is they're fighting for justice against sexual orientation. And they're trying to get a transcript of the court case to find out, why was he met with such leniency? You know what I'm saying? Why was he able to murder this young woman? And she died in the hospital, and he not get jailed or bail. Like, I'm very concerned about this because I feel like, you know what I'm saying, we start seeing actions and we start being desensitized and we start feeling things like this is okay, but it's not. You know what I mean? My aunt was murdered. I know what it's like to lose somebody over, you know, BS. Like, we allow these relationships and how we feel about stuff to affect our actions and start harming each other. That's when we lose as a civilization. You can't do shit like this, bruh. So we're going to keep up with this court case. His name was, oh, bitch ass. What's his name? I probably didn't even write it down because I didn't even want to speak his old bitch ass name. His last name is Johnny with an I. It's a bitch ass nigga. So Johnny with an I, Mr. Johnny with an I, fuck you and the cows that you own. in South Africa. And I hope that you get what you deserve. And that's, you know, to go to jail for this, because this is ridiculous. And my condolences go out to the Zakika family and, you know, all the people in South Africa that's fighting this fight. You know, we're going to keep hope alive. You feel me? On a brighter note, though, this weekend about to be, this is a stupid segue. I don't know how you could go from something like that to the parties this weekend, but we're going to do it. This weekend, tonight, actually, it's a turn up at the High Society has a turn up going on. It's not the one with the cat poetess, but the other one with the girl. Yeah, bam. Minaj Thursdays is tonight. It's the new lesbian night, Women for Women. I might turn up here. It's 8011 Wilshire Boulevard. It's birthday parties all day long. One birthday celebration is DJ P Nasty. I wonder what the P stand for. Okay. It's her birthday. And so meet her up there. The door tickets, I believe, are $20. They are enforcing trendy attire. So you got to come like kind of, you know, kind of cute. I mean, you was already going to do that, but just know that they won't let you in if you're not trendy. So go meet them tonight. Tomorrow, we had our guest on. See you next. Yeah, they're going to have Friday. They're going to be at the Brack Shop Tavern. And, you know, that's 525 West 7th Street, downtown L.A. That's at 9 o'clock Friday. So that's tomorrow. So turn up this weekend. And on Saturday, go get your credit fixed. You feel me? Go meet Malcolm at the Venice Beach. And find out what's up with your credit. You feel me? And get your shit together. That's all I'm trying to do. I'm trying to educate you and help you get your shit together. You feel me? Let's get it together. Let's talk about it. You know what I'm saying? And support Black Dollars Matter. Bam, got my Living Single hat. Got my Malcolm X hat. I'm lit. I don't know about you, but I feel like I got like 3 new fits, because I'm going to wear it one time like it's different with the red hat. And then I'm going to wear it another time like it's a whole nother outfit with the black hat. So I feel like this is 2 outfits, right? And I'm going to wear it without the hat. That's 3 outfits. You feel me? Then I can wear it without the shirt. Bam, 4, 5. I'm winning. You know what I'm saying? So catch me in the streets with my new 5 outfits. And catch me next week. We're here every week with a different guest host. I'm going to be here with the same energy. It's your girl, Shelly Shell, in the building. This has been Let's Talk. I see you next week. I love you for watching. For real, for real.